Hi, I'm Eric from Rocky Mountain ATVMC.com, and today I'm going to show you how to split the cases and to replace crank bearings and a crankshaft. We'll need some common hand tools and also some specialty tools made by Tusk. First of all, we have our case splitter tool, our circlip pliers, our crank puller installer, our clutch hub holder. It also doubles as a flywheel holder. We'll also introduce some other Tusk tools later on. We're going to start with the top end removed, the antifreeze drained, the oil drained, and we want to do a couple things before we pull the bottom end from the frame. And what we're going to do is we're going to pull the flywheel off. To do that, we need to remove the ignition cover, remove the clutch cable, and then we're going to use our Tusk clutch hub holder, which also doubles as a flywheel holder, and remove the flywheel bolt. Then we're going to use our Tusk flywheel puller, and we're going to, it's actually a, you can see it's a left-handed thread. This tool is really important, and it makes it necessary to get this off. Pull the flywheel. Then we need to go ahead and use our impact screwdriver. It's a K&L. It's actually makes it really nice to remove some of these Phillips head screws that are in tight. On this bike, there's a little Allen head that holds the clutch actuator. Go ahead and pull that out. Then we're going to pull our stator off. Set it to the side. Now we went ahead and we've removed it from the frame, and we're going to start on the clutch side. To start with, we're just going to go ahead and remove the clutch cover, and then remove the outer pressure plate bolts. Do it in a crisscross pattern so there's no warpage. Go ahead and pull that out, and you can see there's a spring in the bolt. Go ahead and pull that pressure plate off, and then the clutch plates, both steel and the fiber plates. Now I need to go ahead and remove the clutch lifter. It has a thrust washer on it, and also the clutch lifter rod. Notice how it come out, because it needs to go back in the same way. And then there is a lock washer on this bolt. You just go ahead and pry it off, and then we're going to use our Tusk clutch hub holding tool. Make sure you don't tighten your holding tool too tight. You don't want to distort the shape of the clutch hub. Go ahead and pull that off, and we're going to need to be careful and make sure what's on the back side. There's normally a washer of some sort. Next off, the outer basket comes off, and inside that there is a sleeve, a double roll bearing, and then a washer. We'll need to make sure that it goes back in the same way it comes out. Next, we're going to take off the outer cover. And when we do this, we want to make sure that we pull it off careful. We'll try not to upset the kickstart gear or spring. And anytime you pull off something like that, look for washers on the back side. Now we're going to reinstall the outer clutch basket so that we can remove the primary drive gear. And we're going to go ahead and take a soft aluminum washer and actually wedge it in between the gears. The aluminum won't hurt the teeth, but it won't allow it to spin either. Go ahead and pull the outer basket back off. And then make sure this assembly comes, pay attention to how it comes off, because it'll need to go back on the same way. Make sure there's nothing else on there. Now we're going to take our Tusk snap ring pliers and remove our kickstart idler gear. Once again, check for washers. We're going to remove our shift shaft. And then the two bolts that holds our shift pawls on. And when you take this out, try to remove it as an assembly. It's hard to get the springs back into the pawls for reassembly. Next, we're going to take the star detent off the end of the shift drum. Go ahead and remove that. And as you're removing it, you notice on the back side there's a notch, so when you reinstall it, that notch needs to align with the dowel. Now we've got that side done, we're going to go to the other side, back over to the ignition countershaft side. I'm going to remove the case half bolts. Make sure you get them all. There seems to always be a hidden bolt. In part two, we're going to continue splitting our cases using the Tusk case splitter. And then we'll also begin assembly using our crank puller installer.